Hello from the northeast corner of the USA and welcome to Lake Placid in New York State. It'll be a stunning backdrop for the next 10 days of sporting drama and endeavor. Well, we're at the Lake Placid Olympic Center. You can feel the sporting history here. It's hosted two Olympic Games, including that legendary ice hockey match between the USA and the Soviet Union at the 1980 Olympics. We'll have more on that later.
University Sports Federation World University Games. Tonight, we celebrate our athletes, the legacy of the games, and the rich history of Lake Placid.
Sokoli, Sayago, hello, greetings. I'm Oneida Nation Wolf Clan. We thank and greet you all, for this is a truly a special day. So let it be that we'll be thinking of peace in our minds. So let it be these words. To.
Quayo yanale, quayo yanale, quayo yanale, quayo yanale, te etinu ala dosne ongwe soma, te etinu ala dos ye kesta onja. Deatinu ala dos ne onega so a tunya duhak ne wa nikula kwayo yanale kwayo yanale kwayo yanale kwayo yanale kwayo yanale kwayo yanale.
The dancers are out, and that means it's time to meet the stars of the show. The athletes that have come from around the world to challenge themselves across 12 winter sports. Around 1,400 young athletes are going to be parading around this ice rink.
Argentina! This is Argentina.
Argentina's flag bearer is Franco D'Alfara from cross-country skiing, representing the University of Rio Negro.
Australia. Danny Carr won Australia's first FISU Games winter medals in 1985.
And Australia, represented by 25 athletes, will be competing in seven of the 12 sports here in Lake Placid.
Austria. In 1951, Austria hosted the first FISU winter event.
And they're led by Anna Petuchnik, a regular top three finisher in the Europe Cup of speed skating. She studies law at the University of Innsbruck.
Canada has,
and they've come with the third largest team here this year, 121 in total,
and six for women.
Two flag bearers, one male, one female. It's Alexander Maycock and Caroline Beecham.
People's Republic of China. The Chengdu 2021 FISU World University Games Summer.
China being led out by Han Yu from the curling team,
from July 28th,
which is representing Beijing Sports University, and represented China at the Beijing Olympics last year, as well as the Youth Olympic Games in 2016 in the mixed doubles.
The Czech ski resort of Spindlerud Mountain hosted two editions of Winter FISU Games.
94 athletes representing the Czech Republic. Tomáš Klinský is the alpine skier that's carrying the flag from the Czech Technical University in Prague, selected for his achievements in the last winter Universiade in 2019 in Krasnoyarsk, where he earned a silver medal in the individual Super-G.
France. Chamonix-France hosted the first ever FISU World University Games in winter.
Well, obviously a big alpine destination for ski fans is French Alps. And the flag bearer comes from a university very much in the foothills of those Alps, Grenoble Alps University. It's figure skater Maya Mazzara.
United Kingdom of Great Britain and Northern Ireland. The United Kingdom has won a medal in curling at the last five FISU Winter Games.
Flag bearing being shared by Josh Crane and Lisa Davey. Great Britain's brought 62 athletes representing about 35 universities, from Norwich to the Highlands of Scotland, from Glasgow to Portsmouth. The majority of them, no surprise here, competing in curling and ice hockey.
Germany. Germany is preparing to host its second FISU World University Games summer in 2025 in Rhein-Ruhr.
41 athletes representing Germany at these games. And the man with the flag is Jakob Leurer, the University of Würzburg, where he studies medicine.
Haiti. Haiti is making its debut at the FISU Games winter with Carlens Millay competing in cross-country skiing.
There he is. Good luck to the man from Haiti, making history.
Japan. Japan is the most represented Asian country since the start of the Winter FISU Games.
Yeah, they also have the second largest team here, 139 athletes who compete in all the 12 sports here at Lake Placid. So we're halfway through this parade.
Republic of Korea. Korea will be hosting World University Games summer in 2027.
Once again, the fourth FISU flag carrying is being shared for this figure skater Shi-Yong Lee, speed skater Min-Jo Kim, who's the winner of last year's President's Cup.
Norway. Norway won 8 medals during the last winter of FISU Games in 2019.
Flag bearer Magnus Boe represented Norway internationally once before at the 2019 IBU Junior World Championships in Slovakia.
Switzerland. The first FISU headquarters were located in Switzerland in 1949.
Well, a country synonymous with winter sports and represented here by 55 athletes. The biggest contingent are competing in alpine skiing. And there are 10 cross-country skiers here, too.
Slovakia. Slovakia has hosted 3 editions of the FISU Winter Games.
That is the captain of the men's ice hockey team, Martin Magdalen.
Ukraine. Ukraine has won 76 medals in the Winter FISU Games since 1991.
And Ukraine have brought 58 athletes here. And they've had a real effect on the town of Lake Placid. Everywhere they go in those blue and yellow uniforms, they get stopped and people chat to them and ask them about what's going on. And new friendships made.
United States of America. The Lake Placid 1972 Winter FISU World University Games were the first in North America.
And being led out by a local boy who's lived in Lake Placid all his life, Van Ledger. Biathlete studies at Montana State University, so the host nation are on the ice. They're the biggest team at these games, 150 athletes, many of them from the world of ice hockey. And what a place to come and compete at, because this is hallowed ice for American ice hockey. It was here that we saw one of the most famous moments in sport, arguably the greatest match of ice hockey in Olympic history. It became known as the Miracle on Ice. FISU World University Games, the largest multi-sport winter event on the globe after the Winter Olympics. That's an incredible stat.
Welcome to Lake Placid. You made it. You made it. What a magnificent stage on which to bring back together the world of university sports. This stadium and many of the venues in which you will compete over the coming 11 days are part of our universal sports heritage. At FISU, we know sport can never truly be dissociated from wider global society, which is why I am so glad and encouraged to see the world students athletes come together in a spirit of peaceful endeavor and competition in the coming 11 days. I wish you all good luck and success.
Good evening, everyone. Welcome to New York. I'm Governor Kathy Hochul. I could not be prouder to host all of you in this most beautiful part of our state. Proud that New York State is the only state in America that has hosted the World University Games, not once, not twice, but three times. Tonight is certainly a charm. We welcome you with hearts full of love. So to our athletes, I welcome you, and let this place be a miracle for all of you. Let this be a place that you begin memories that you'll cherish for the rest of your lives. And with that I say, let the 2023 World University Games begin. Thank you.
Please rise for the International University Sports Federation anthem.
Move on to the all-important athlete and officials' oaths.
Please welcome Middlebury College student and United States figure skater Ting Zhuang, and Lake Placid resident and official for biathlon Dan Nardiello to take the oath on behalf of the athletes and officials.
On behalf of the student athletes, I promise that we shall take part in the FISU World University Games, respecting and abiding by the rules which govern it, committing ourselves to a sport without doping and without drugs, in the true spirit of sportsmanship, fair play, for the glory, for the honor of our teams, and for the achievement of international university sport movement.
The beautiful Lake Placid 2023 torch and cauldron radiate light from clean, renewable energies. We can eliminate carbon from our atmosphere and power our lives. Together, we can save winter. Jim Miller is a two-time Olympian in Nordic combined and is bringing history back to Lake Placid. Bill McKibben is an environmentalist, author, journalist, and distinguished scholar. He has written extensively on the impact of global warming. Andrew Weibrecht, Lake Placid native, grew up training at Whiteface Mountain and is a 2010 Olympic bronze medalist and a 2014 Olympic silver medalist in alpine skiing. Mark Grimmett is a Lake Placid resident and a five-time Olympian for U.S. Luge. Billy DeMond grew up jumping here at the Olympic Jumping Complex and skiing at Mount Van Hovenburg. He competed in five consecutive Olympic Games. Art Lucy was born and raised in the Olympic region, was an alpine captain at Dartmouth College. He is joined by one of his three children, Nina Lucy, Lake Placid native, four-time U.S. national ski jumping champion.
So the opening ceremony is building to a climax now with a number of, we've got some really lovely creative pieces coming up. This first one is called Gathering in the Light and is performed by the American Ice Theater. By the way, when we go to a wide shot, keep an eye out for the ice dancing cameraman. His work really brings this to life. In their work, the American Ice Theater. Two skaters for this second sequence, Angela Kim and Pavel Velchuski, in what they describe as a celebration of the power of athletes of the games and of coming together. Final artistic piece now, and this celebrates winter with the message that winter is worth saving from global warming. Back on the ice, Sarah Sporich. Well, Well, we've seen some terrific performances on the ice already tonight. I can't wait to see the sporting performances once the figure skating, the short track speed skating, the ice hockey gets underway here. Support for these games from the locals of Lake Placid, and Art and Nina are going to go and light the eco torch powered by sustainable energy. There it is. No fossil fuels burned here. There it is. The cauldron is lit. The games are underway. So the opening ceremony is done. Time for the sport to begin. We have 10 days of thrilling action to come. 12 sports, over 1,400 athletes across 9 iconic venues. And they really are. Keep an eye out for the ski jumping venue surrounded by forest. And the outdoor speed skating with its amazing high school backdrop. It's awesome. Dreams will be made over the coming days. So wherever you're watching around the world, make sure you don't miss a thing. I'll leave you with a final dance. And from me, Alec Wilkinson, it's goodbye.
Best of luck to the athletes of the Lake Placid 2023 FISU World University Games. Thank you for joining us this evening, and good night, everyone.